Ja, vad säger? Det är prita, ja. Well, I've been filming for the next, for the past 2 minutes, eh?
Cut. No. Yeah, you have 2 minutes with of nothing.
No, it's not 1 minute, it's 30 seconds.
30 seconds?
Yes.
Okay, but you can cut. Start again.
No.
Cut. First of all, salute all subscribers and viewers. Thanks for your support, for visiting our channel, for all your comments, for your subscriptions, and for sharing and spreading the passion from this channel for the RC place to the rest of the world. Of course, yes. Also thanks for your subscriptions. And for sharing our video, I say, the more you share, the more people will see this amazing and beautiful hobby. And of course, after that, we hope that as many as possible will click on something and have fun.
Yes. Enough? That is the whole point in the life, so to have fun.
We can't find better hobby than flying RC planes, so we want to persuade you to click for the first time and try to fly a plane. It doesn't matter what kind of plane, as long as you're in the air and you're having fun. Of course, once you will try, you will be an addict, but like we have said many times, this is a good addiction. It will cost you some money, but it will give you the best memories in the world.
Yes, now, enough.
Let's get to the point today. I won't talk too much what we have. Of course, maybe this is, again, another option for you to click, and another option for you, I will tell you this, if you would love to have the Bolsa ugly stick plane, and this is something unbelievable, for a very good price, and really affordable. Of course, you will have the link below, check it, if you like it, click or not, who cares, but believe me that it will be worth it. Of course, just a few words what we have today. Of course, this is the third plane,
yes,
from this new company that we are unboxing lately, and that is the Dancing Wings Hobby. The Bolsa planes that also comes, you can get them in the plug and fly version if you are an electro lover. Of course, on all these planes you can also stick the glow engines on, but we are showing this for all the electro lovers. But that doesn't mean that you always need to have the foam plane on the electro. You can also have beautiful Bolsa plane put on electro. Now, I will just show you quick before we unbox this beautiful plane. Show you the previous one that we had unboxed. You have seen the unboxing of this. The beautiful and sexy 1.6 meter Fissler Storch.
Yes.
I mean, look at this and be impressed. Now we can see something. The last time we have shown you this was still in the box, in the pieces. Show the box, I will just remove this. This will be something extra, my friends, for this filming. And of course, our dear and sexy Captain Blush was assembling this bird for me, eh?
Yes, it's the truth.
Because he is the assembler, he is the hardcore modeler, he has more experience than me. But the next one, I have assembled myself one plane, that bobber, and I really had a good time. And of course, I will try to assemble this stick.
Yes.
We will see it later, Captain Blush. The point is now here.
Well, to tell the truth, when I was assembling this, the user's manual how to assemble is very, very easy.
They and really have good instruction manual for the assembly, and look how the plane looks good now. I mean, now we have the surface inside. It even has the working slats. Now, do you see now this, eh?
Yes.
And Captain Blush, what you were using this all the time, just the CA glue.
Just as it is in the manual.
CA glue.
Good CA glue. I have prepared everything for Robert, so he now just needs to make the servo connections, and that's it.
I just make the connections, set the plane.
Only for the wings, because the fuselage is already done.
And of course, show the fuselage. I mean, look at this, a beautiful wheels, and the plane really, really looks sexy. Look at this inside, even the motor is already on.
No, what is interesting, the motor mount goes inside the fuselage. So it is cube shaped. So you just push it inside, you measure the length of the cowling, and you just screw it in, and that's it.
And my friends, in a few days, of course, I will stuck in the receiver now, put the push rods on, and that's it. And we will see this beautiful, sexy plane on the maiden flight. I think that we will be able to take off on our runway.
Yes.
I mean, the wheels are not big, but still, I think that they're big enough. If you have a short-cutted grass, or maybe a magic carpet like ours, and I will be able to take off. Of course, this is enough. And of course, I will just tell you this now, put that away, that for the fourth unboxing of the Dancing Wings hobby will be the masterpiece. And I think that one of the best and the most beautiful planes that by now you can get from this company, and that is the beautiful PT-17 Sturmanay.
Yes.
Of course, also plug-and-fly version, but enough, Captain Blush.
Metal gear service, yes.
Everything that you need inside of the box, of course, still for the electro lovers, and that's it. And now let's get to the affordable, ugly steed in the Balsa version. Let's see it for the first time on this channel. And to tell you the truth, I don't think that I have seen any unboxing of this plane by now on YouTube. Okay, I will start here. Let's check quick.
The landing gear.
I mean, one thing that I can already see inside here, I mean, look how good this is packed. I mean,
every thing is packed.
Look, separately.
As
someone took time to do all this on every single piece, and that is what I love. Not that you get the plane and already inside the box, half of the plane is ruined. I mean, look at this. And this is, according to the weight, the aluminum landing gear, but painted in the white. I mean, look at this, eh?
Oh.
They didn't leave it in the silver, but they have actually gone through the trouble and painted that.
Yes, and it is 3 millimeters thick.
Really good, eh? And this one will be the first one.
I don't know about the inches, but 3 millimeters is quite thick.
Yeah, of course it is, eh?
Yes.
And look at the wheels, look. Really sexy, eh? And I think that this one will be perfect for our, even for our grass runway, Captain Blush.
Yes.
Of course, next, also a goodies, look at this, eh? The back wheel, the screws, the horns, everything
control
that you need.
Horns.
I mean, the hardware is, of course, in the one box.
Tail wheel.
And later we will see, of course, I can't wait to see the electronic set that they have put it inside this one. And we will see the wingspan. I think that it is, everything here is around 1.6 meter wingspan. The wheel pants, but look at this, what for they're made from. Do you see this? From the fiberglass. Fiberglass.
Do you know how hard this is?
Yeah, of course it is, because it is fiberglass. And this needs to be hard, because on the landings, many times,
you can be
wheel pants get
ruined,
eh? But this one, they will work perfect. Of course, you must understand, like I have said, that this is not some kind of plug-and-fly version planes, that all that you have to do is just put two or three bolts inside.
Am I seeing flaps here?
Yeah, of course, Captain Blush. That you just have to put two or three screws together and you're ready to go to the runway. With this kind of planes, you will also experience how the real models look like if you have the almost ready to fly version to assemble, because this one needs more work. But don't be scared, all that you need is the CA glue, really good CA glue.
Do you know what I like about this assembly?
No, tell me.
The servo just goes inside, there is nothing to do, no servo boxes or nothing, just put him inside and that's it.
This will be sexy. Of course, flaps or ailerons, I don't know what we will see later, of course.
I think these are...
And you can see here that it already has the CA hinges inside. And of course, if I check, look, always check this.
They are glued.
Because on these kind of planes, even if you will have this stuck in the wind, that doesn't mean that it is glued already. Don't forget, on the IRF versions, you must check. Many times also the one side, nothing is glued. But I can check here that in fact one side is
and this one is
glued. Then you stuck it inside, leave enough room and just tuck, 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 put the CA glue inside here and that's it, eh? You're ready to go away. I mean, it's not so hard, even though, like I said, don't be afraid of the planes like this, and at least one you must have, so you will have the experience of assembling yourself a beautiful
plane. Hey, do you see this? Hey, look at the back. Everything is labeled 448. This is the type of the plane. Look at this. It's also 448.
So they know what.
So when they are packaging it, they know what goes with what plane.
And I can see already, Captain Blush, here that in fact this will be the flap also version.
Yes.
And I will leave this for the rest.
For the last.
I have for the last, because here is the electronics that comes extra inside. If you will just usually you order the plane, it comes like this, but in the plug and fly version, if you will order it, you will have also this inside. Let's go to the next one. Look at this. How they have secured the fuselage. Do you see the first time? It is pumped with the air. Do you see this? Of course, I will take off first the wings.
Oh,
and this
green again.
This is your color, eh? Oh. And since, hey, don't worry.
What?
Because I will have the spectrum receiver inside. And since you have now the spectrum radio also, you will be able to do also the flight with this. We will see your maiden flight with this plane and you will tell us your experience. That is why we have
yes, and we will do each, that.
We each have the spectrum radios so we can do the reviews.
You can do. Well, there will be actually two maiden flights.
But look how sexy this is packed. Yeah, because, I mean, it's interesting. If I do the maiden flight and Captain Blush is flying this plane again for the first time, I mean, that is still the maiden flight for you, Captain Blush.
Of course it is.
And now let's check the quality of this plane for the first time.
I will come
time.
Closer because this is sick, eh?
Because for the wings, this is it, eh?
Just put the servo. Look, the string, so you can pull the wires.
The string is inside to put the wires. You can see the string here. It is glued.
Again, you see?
Yeah.
448.
448. Of course, here we can see that where it will go the carbon bar. Yes. And of course, one is already here to grab the wings. I can also see that this will be
bolt together
construction. I can see something here. Something will go inside.
Yeah, we
here.
Will see.
The first one. But look at this. Look at this stick. I mean, look at this access. And it's really, I mean, it's amazing. One thing that I have noticed, the balsa is always light. But this, dancing wing hobby planes, I mean, really, really light wings. Yeah.
This is feather light.
Yeah. You have to check to believe it how light it is, and it's really great because.
And maybe next time we must have scale with us, eh?
Yeah. But once I know that the plane is light, that already means that it will fly great, eh? Because heavy planes, I don't know, heavy planes.
Yeah, is there something written on the wing?
Behave heavy, yeah, of course. And this is it, eh? The dancing wings hobby, eh?
Yes.
Like this?
Yes.
Maybe I will cut this out and this
I will come closer to it again. Yes, like this. Perfect.
Maybe this will be for the thumbnail. I mean, look at this. But look at this. And look at this beautiful, beautiful.
Chuck, well, this is 1.5.
Yeah.
4, something like that.
Yeah, I will check, of course.
There is a manual inside.
Uh-huh, we have the manual here. I will grab it at once. Specifications, of course.
Show me.
Show this. Okay. Show this to the viewers.
1.4 meters.
Yeah. So we finally know. And this is such a good size. This can fit in every car. You don't even need to disassemble the plane.
For us, 6 channels.
Yeah, but look at it.
Look what you need.
I mean, really good instruction manuals. They really put good instruction manuals inside. Everything is shown to you with the pictures.
Even how you drill it, eh?
Yeah, with the real pictures.
90 degree angle, you just put the pull wires through. This is the, I always told you that the servos are mounted. Pretty good, eh?
Of course, this one you will have the link to this place. It will be to the BitGo Hobby store in the USA. I will salute BitGo Hobby, eh? And even Bobby Kmita, he's working there with the pilot truck.
Yeah, of course.
But of course, look how sexy the plane will look. Next, what? The prop. Look at the prop.
But look at this again. How they took time,
eh? I mean, when you see this, look how they have packed. When have you seen?
It looks like a magical straw.
Yeah, but when have you seen the last time the carbon bar? Secured in the foam. I'm salute for this.
Yes.
Because usually it's just stuck somewhere inside. But this time, look. Even this is somebody took the time to secure this. Of course, I can hear also something.
Push wires for the elevator and the rudder.
This is why they have secured this. But they have thought really good.
Yes.
Where to put it? Well, put it inside, inside the carbon bar. I mean, this is great,
And this is also, so it doesn't hurt nothing.
I just wonder, because as you can see this. Ah, there are.
Yeah, Z bands.
Ah, we have the Z bands here. And this is something that allows Z band, and then this side just goes inside that.
Servo, that linkage.
That linkage that you just put the. What's that? The hex screw or something.
Yeah.
It's really easy. Really easy,
to
set this one. I love it. And a really, really good carbon bar. Of course, next, let's check quick.
The elevator and the rudder.
The elevator and the rudder. And look at this foam, I just love this foam.
Hey, even the underneath,
Yeah, underneath, can you imagine? When have you seen underneath the protection for something, this is something.
Protected from all sides.
If you pay your money for this, at least it can be packed good, because it's so frustrating to collect and save the money for you to buy something. You're so happy to finally click, and then when the plane came, you took it out of the box and it's ruined. I mean, that is the saddest thing that the motor can experience,
Yes.
The crashed plane in the box, I mean, that is, you can't forgive that. That is unforgivable, Oh, look at this, Oh, the two parts, of course, look at this, But it's so good packed, You even need to take time to unpack this, Of course, check again.
The elevator.
One side already glued inside. Mm-hmm. Like this, This will look sexy. I mean, it looks like a lot of parts, but believe me, this will go together pretty quick. It
of
won't
course.
Take so much time, Oh, I can see here the hoist.
Yes. Already.
But of course, one thing that you need to be careful when you're assembling this, to make good angles, Captain Wash?
Yes.
So everything.
Take your time. If you need to use the duct tape.
Use duct tape or something
degrees.
That this will really be on 90 degrees on the plane. Don't just stuck it inside. That doesn't mean that it's okay. You must check, measure, and also this angles. Really, you must be, this is important, but this will take time.
You must not rush when you're assembling the plane.
Because the most time, the consuming time, the most consuming time process is to put the back of the plane together, the back of the plane. The rest is not so hard. Of course, the prop, Captain, I'll show the prop.
Uh-huh.
And now I will, I love this, I mean, look how they pack this, look at this,
Let me show you, propeller.
Put it there, look how they have thought. They have put this protection down and then around the fuselage. I mean, this is unbelievable.
Light?
This is like, it's less weight than one pack of sugar that you have in the coffee. I mean, this is unbelievable. Can you imagine how good flyer this will be? Because already it is so light. This is sick, Let's check quick, of course. Inside here today we won't see some connector for the battery because the electronics.
I think that the connector is already on the ESC.
Yeah, the connector is on ESC.
And we see. And on the previous one was XT60, so.
Yeah, maybe even on this one.
Yeah, of course it is.
That it will be. That all will be the same.
Because this is now the most common connector in the world, I think.
Because I think that most of these planes will fly on 4S batteries.
Yes.
But of course,
look at this green color.
By the word, read the instruction manual. But this is really, really cool.
Looks like a Kawasaki Ninja,
Some sport motorbike, Sexy, color, fast, It looks fast already, tell me this,
Look at this. Look. Here comes out the control. 448 again,
And you don't even have to screw with the stickers. This is one thing, because usually you get the plane, you need to put all the stickers and you're checking what the hell in the box, how should I put the stickers on. Sometimes you don't even have the instruction manual inside how the stickers look. But this time they have put it, because you have enough work to assemble the plane. Screw the stickers,
Show me.
But look at the inside. Uh-huh. And how good the foil is covered, It's really good covered.
This is really light,
Yeah, Captain Blasch, I have told you, the whole plane, I just wonder, I can read here,
Here goes the servos.
What's the weight of the plane? Yeah, totally, look at this, Look at this, the flying weight, my friends. The flying weight is from 1.5 to 1.6. I mean, this is nothing, eh? 1.5, this is the loaf of bread, eh?
448 again.
Yeah, just for this plate.
The magnets, exactly. There are the hooks in front.
This is sexy.
Hooks inside. That's it, eh?
This is sexy.
Now put the
fuselage. Shall I put it here?
Yes.
Of course, I won't assemble nothing because the next time you will see, I can leave it like this. It's good enough. But hey, it will be great. And of course, the last thing is, let's check what kind of electronics they put inside. Mm-hmm. I will put this here. Good enough, eh? I will open this.
Now show us the goodies.
Because, like I have said, this is another version. Of course, like I have said, you can order this without anything, or you can order it with this, eh? Let's see what's inside here, look.
Oh, I can already see, eh? Metal Gear Servos.
This time they have done it. Of course, the Y harnesses, look at this, eh?
Yes.
You have what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5?
Yeah, six. Four in the wings servos. And two in the fuselage.
And this is something that I love this time, eh? This time I love the fact that there are Metal Gear Servos inside this plane, eh? Because this should be some aerobatic plane, so that means that it will need some much better servos than just some phony baloney
plastic
ones. And let's check the motor, of course, look at this. 900 kVs, I mean, pretty sexy motor, huh?
Oh, yeah.
The motor, how do you call this? The motor...
The prop shaft.
The prop shaft already on.
And the motor mount.
The motor mount, and of course, let's check this.
You don't have to open
it. For XT60 again, and of course, it always comes with this kind. ZTM, I have this.
Oh,
ESC is the nowhere.
60 amp.
When I was ordering, the stuff, those EDF units for those small planes, 50mm one, I all have this.
The same ones?
ZTM was this called, and they work perfect. I can tell you right now from my experience that this ESC is a perfect, they work, eh?
Yes.
Captain Blush, eh? Maybe just a little bit. I will just put it like this and just one wing on one side and one on the other, so we will see a little. I mean, we all know how the ugly stick looks, but hey. I mean, this is not the ugly stick, this is the stick. Not the ugly stick, but the stick.
Stick 14.
But hey, I will have fun with this, hey. Huh?
Yes.
And can you imagine, my friends, I mean, you have also have some foam versions on the market. I will tell you that, but hey, if you have the option, hey, why not to have the Bulsa version, eh? The Bulsa version. And of course, what I was saying is, eh? We didn't say, I said that I thought that it will be, yeah, of course, like I said,
Forza.
The 4S power, and that is what kind of battery?
22 to 28.
Right. 22 to 28, I mean, this is unbelievable. This is the most common battery. 2200 free cell, and of course, 2200 4 cell batteries. Hey, I can't wait, that is all that I need to say, eh?
This
and of course
it.
We can see here that this will be the compartment for the battery to get inside, eh?
Yes.
I will just put some Velcro inside and some strap, eh? Yeah. And I will have the fun to assemble this. I will, this one, Captain Blush, I will assemble myself, eh?
Yes, you will, and you will enjoy it.
I will enjoy the assembly of this. I will just follow the instruction manual and that's it, eh? What to tell at the end of this unboxing? Well, hey, by now I'm really impressed, eh? I'm impressed with the quality of the plane, how the Bulsa is made, how the plane is covered. I'm really impressed with the weight of this plane, because it's really light, so that means that it will even feel really light in the air, and if the plane feels light, you have a joy to fly it. It's a joy to fly a light plane. But still, it is 1.4 meter wingspan, perfect for every car, eh? Everything that you need. It will even handle our grass runway, I think, eh? And it comes in the plug-and-fly version with beautiful and sexy Metal Gear servos, ESC, and the motor, all that you need. All that you need now is the enthusiasm, the passion for the RC planes, battery, receiver, and radio, and that's it, and the C8 UI. And that is why I love this. You don't need 100,000 different glues. All that you need is the CA glue to put the plane together. And it holds.
That's it. Yes.
And I will just show you. I will show you once what CA glue I will use if we're already talking about DSA. I mean, it says it is Slovenian, but this kind of glue and this one, I mean, you have many versions of this. Some dry fast, You have the gel CA glues, I don't know what. But Captain Blush found this one in the store, and my friends, it's amazing. It dries together really fast, and that's important. Not insane fast, but just enough that you put it on, you hold it for 10, 15 seconds, and it's enough so you can release it. And that is what I love. Because some contact glues like this, they don't dry, I don't know. I have the one because, I mean, these are meant to be that if you just do this, you won't be able to put the fingers away anymore. But sometimes, hey, I leave the plane here for an hour, and when I come back, the steel, it is not dried. But this one is perfect.
Yes, this is it.
Enough, Captain Blush.
Another unboxing, and then dinner, lunchtime.
Pilot Robert and Captain Blush are able to be beautiful and sexy. Another option for you to click or not, who cares? But I can recommend it right now because I know that it's perfect. The Dancing Wings Hobby Stick 14. Sports aeroplane, it does have the ailerons, the flaps, everything that you need, power and full cell, and even I will tell you this, the flaps and the ailerons, that means that on this plane, you will be able to set yourself all kind of stuff, and Captain Blush, I think that for once, this will be the first time, I will take the 6-channel receiver, and I will set myself here also, those crazy settings with the ailerons and the flaps, that you can use the both surfaces as the ailerons, or you can use the surfaces as the normal flaps or the butterfly to really slow down fast. And this will be the first time that we will test this. This is great, my friends. This is great. That means that, again, you can expect some crazy flights for Pilot Robert and Captain Blush and more fun on this channel. Thanks again, eh? Don't wait too long, eh? You have the link below, so click quick, at least check, eh? And you will see all kind of stuff in the store. Everything that you need, from the batteries to radios to the planes, any kind of plane, say don't wait because you never know what will happen tomorrow. Life can be so short and you will really...
Hey, save something for the next video, eh?
Yeah, of course, but even for me, the day will come and I will stop to fly and I will be sorry for every single day that I had the chance to fly and click on something, but I did. Don't wait. So this is it.
Yes.
We love you all again. Thanks, and I will also salute what? Alexander Sikirnik, for this hat, because in fact this is the true captain's hat from our former beautiful Adria Airways airline company, which is dead, but it still lives in so many hearts of the pilots and captains, and the stewardesses,
yes.
I don't know what, even in my heart. Enough?
Enough, yes.